I'm trying to win every Champions League on the planet in Football Manager. However, now I'm unemployed after episode 1, as I didn't win any title with Junior Sporting, and we are already in 2028. I also only have 1-star reputation. Kylian Mbappé is already 29, so I'm definitely not going to manage him anytime in the future. I really hoped I would be able to do it, but apparently not. However, then I got a pretty impressive offer. Welcome to Enugu Rangers. They are a team in Nigeria, and I think a pretty insane crew for me to be able to manage them. They have 2-star reputation, they haven't won the Champions League though, but they have won the Cup Winners' Cup, and I think they actually are the second best team in the division, behind Premier Stars, and they even had a bit of a budget. So I find it some interesting transfers, and you're able to see them here. Most of them are pretty young but have pretty high potential, like Terry Monakwana, a potential of 176, and he is already our first goalkeeper joining from Police 11. On a 3, then we also have Stanley Morgas, already scoring 6-9 and a potential of 178, joining from Botswana. There's also Joe Zamba, Bala, a midfielder. He is playing it difficult to settle in the area though, but a potential ability of 156 and a pretty high count ability. That's mainly why I got him. Then we have Guam Ola, a left back and left midfielder with a potential of 179. Not that prolific, although 7 games and 5 assists and goals is pretty decent. Then we have Son Hamonga, who hasn't played a game so far, from Bhutan. Central midfielder, only a count ability of 80 and potential ability of 179. High ambition and professionalism though. And there's also Christ Bitsamu, who I got from Congo. He's actually a citizen of both Congos, already playing for us, 122 count ability and 167 for potential, 4 goals already. Sebo Mokwadi from Botswana, the only guy I actually paid money for, 119 count ability and 105.7 potential ability. Almost forgetting my words there. And the last person, Tahibo Tayana, Tanyana, I think, I'm not really sure. Not playing so far, but a potential of 177, and that far into the season we are in second place behind Premier Stars. We need to win the league to get into the Champions League, or second for the African Cup of Nations, I think that's the name, or Confederations Cup. By the way, last season they only got 6th, I think that's why they sacked the last manager, or maybe he retired. No, he got sacked actually. Oh, and now he is an unemployed manager. Okay, he's actually assistant manager with Nigeria. That's definitely a step up, I feel like. He actually has both worlds in real life, I think. That's interesting. Wait a minute, I have to look him up. Is that actually correct? Okay, I butchered that name. He's still a manager there, but not for Nigeria. Okay, maybe they don't show it here. Time to go to the end of season 1. And we have finally done it, I've won a title. And we won the title by 13 points, so pretty dominant season. The tactic definitely was helpful there, and there's just a bunch of green. Although we lost 1-6 to Shooting Stars, we definitely got obliterated there. No great striker for them. Who was our best goal scorer? We don't really have a top goal scorer, but a top assister in Sebo Mokwadi with 15, who is one of the guys I've actually signed, but I think he doesn't settle here. Oh no, he had a contract extension, and he actually used to play for Shooting Stars. Does he like big matches? No, but he doesn't hate him either. 4 goals, 15 assists. However, we went down to being a semi-professional club because we're actually in debt again. There's also no cup in Nigeria, at least not in the database, therefore I sadly can't show you that one. However, next season we are in the Champions League and can hopefully go far there. I signed a bunch of other people by the way. Rashidul Khan from Bangladesh with a potential of 178. Our backup goalkeeper, our new one. Moz Navachuku, who has a potential of 168 but not playing so far. Christopher Nyoko, already playing. Central midfielder. Count ability of 131, potential ability of 184. Only 400k asking price by the way, and got him on a free. Joseph Maswate, another winger who has played with a decent... I don't even know if I signed him. I don't think I've signed him myself. I'm very confused. Oh, I think I know why I signed him. Played for Julinho, but he didn't really play well for them. I don't know why he is here. The save is like 2 months old and I am not sure why he's here. Maybe you know. I don't even know and I've played the save. And he also left to the Kader. I'm even more confused now. Let's ignore that one. We also have Shergul, who has a potential of 178 and is already playing as a striker, scoring 8 and 16. I think I locked a bunch of people in their positions. We have Steven Chitu, interesting name, which I think a bunch of people in Africa have. I don't know what the name means. 98 count ability and 178 potential. Also playing as a defender. Not a tie of RCA at the moment though. Cost me 300k and up to 1.8 million. We have Sunday Samuel, another winger. 7 apps and 3 goals and 1 assist. Count ability of 95, potential ability of 171. Maybe I have overpaid on him. Asking price is 1.3 million. Canadian only, and he isn't really playing for us, and he doesn't like his teammate. Time for season number 2. I'm at the end of season number 2, and first I want to show you the different transfers I've made. Actually, there are only 3. We have one transfer out though, Christopher Nyoko to Al-Nassr, or Al-Wasl, not Al-Nassr, and we made a bit of a profit on him, but I think actually my board sold him because of a financial situation. Anyone else important I've sold? No, I don't think so. But I bought in Francis Diazayakana from Congo. 30 games played, 15 goals and 11 assists in the league. Count ability of 111 and potential of 159. Then there's also Jean-Jacques Mbok, who played 24 times and 1 goal. But he is of course mostly a defender, already 21. 118 count ability and 164 potential ability. Probably hard to catch that at age 21 now. But he's playing for us. Formerly playing for Sport in Cameroon. I think they are by far the best team there. And we also have Tatayaone Mampori. Nailed it. Also 21-year-old striker. 14 games, 8 goals. 1-2-4 counterability and 1-6-1 potential. And we have won my second league title. And again, pretty convincingly. When we start only in 8th place, they completely collapsed. We again don't have a top scorer. But again, a top assister in Sepo Magwadi. Who was the top scorer last year? I've already forgotten it. Can I see that somewhere? Assists? It was actually Magwadi again. So, 2 years in a row. But he has a bit in from Saudi Arabia or UAE maybe. A pretty insane player for us. And he is not a legend for us. No, he is a legend for us. He is the second legend after JJ Okocha. However, we need to look at the Champions League. As I can tell you, we went pretty far. First we beat 3-2 Kings 5-1. Team from Equatorial Guinea. Put him around and then in the first round. We obliterated Diabis Noor. 8-0 over both legs and they are from Congo. Then we get into the group stage after 2 knockout rounds already having been played, which we won in a group with Tunis, a team from Morocco, and Young Africans from South Africa. I think a pretty stacked group actually, even when we stars got through. Then the quarterfinal versus ES Sahel. They went up 2-0 in the first leg, but we then won 3-0 and advanced on away goals, or goal difference actually. Then the semifinal versus when we stars from All Nation, and they won the second leg, but we won the first leg 2-0, and with that we were actually in the final against Al-Ahli, and there we lost the final on penalties. Yeah, over both legs, we actually did pretty well and then we lost it. We almost won it in my second season. I think that's actually pretty insane. By the way, 2 of our pairs in the top 3 goalscorers. And it's time to go to season number 3. But before that, you should definitely subscribe to the channel. Is that where you won't miss any further uploads of the Heptagon Challenge and other games I'm playing? And of course, also if you like to support the video in the series. The end of the 3rd season. We didn't have the player of the month in, I think, July or June. However, we are finally a professional club again. I also have 3-star reputation now, and I'm studying for my Continental A license. Let's start with the transfers again. And there we have 2 outgoings, I think from the board mostly. First, Joe Zambala, after 60 games and 24 goals, from the winger position, overall of 136, and he went to Sydney FC for almost $600,000, big money for Namibia, and a profit as he came in on a free. And also Christ Bitsamu, who left us a defensive midfielder, 76 games and 24 goals, Bargarafa, 133 counterability, and left for almost £700,000, or not pounds, dollar, and of course on a profit. After 3 seasons with a 716 rating or much better, and also doing the job for Algarafa. I only bought in 1 guy in Raymond Nduka. He came in for 120k from Royal Wolves, also Nigeria. He only played 15 times and 1 goal, 111 counterability and 178 potential ability, and an international player. But how did we do in the league? You're probably unsurprised to know that we won it again. And finally a top scorer. We got 100 points and by far the best goal difference, obliterating the league, and Bihaisa United pretty good for a minus 22 goal difference. There should be almost going down with the goal difference. Remus Stars kind of recovering, but Qua United now in 2nd place, playing for the 2nd season in a row, and a 9th Nigerian Premier Division title. Still, Mampori now with 31 goals in 40 games, and countability of 1-2-4, and potential ability of 1-6-1. I've boosted the chance for small nations, by the way, so that you aren't confused. Like, they are more likely to generate good players. We have the 3 best players in the entire division, and Guadalajara, this time with the most assists, title with another guy, and he, for left back, pretty insane. However, only a 7.58 rating. Interesting. You might be asking what happened to our man, Sebo Mukwadi. He actually, he didn't leave for team. He is still here and still playing. However, only assisting 9 this time. Kind of harsh rating in his first season. Still a legend. We also now have an icon in Victor Johnson, who played in our second team as well. And I actually didn't sign him. He was at the club and countability of 128 and potential ability of 174. I don't even know if I've noticed him. I might have ignored him when I actually played because I mostly had transfers. However, he is in the first team, so I must have played him. I must have been aware of him. Only 13 months under contract though. Entire career for Rangers International in Hugo. However, how did we do in the Champions League? Preliminary round. We beat Nevang Galaxy 7-1. Galaxy, not Galaxy. Yeah, from Botswana. And did I just see a second team there? BIC2? Are you a second team? We won the FA Cup and the Super Cup. Who are you? Excuse me? Where can I look that up? They don't have any affiliate. Wait, it's the Obama team. No, Barak FC. No, they only have a first team, might be a typo. Or do they have both teams in the same division? They don't have the two behind it. I'm very confused. So much for them. We definitely beat them. We then played TP Mazibi and beat them 6-0. Then we had the group stage, where we again won a group against Zamalek and other people. Then the quarterfinal, we beat Kaiser Chiefs 5-3 after scoring 4 in the second leg away. We can't feel that though. Semi-final, 4-0 versus Pyramids. And with that, we were in the final versus Zamalek. Civic Swintook, by the way, in the semi-final, and we again lost the final, 1-4. Very frustrating. By the way, my power with the most goals. Harvard tells me that we lost in the preliminary round, apparently. I don't know why. That's not this year. That's definitely kind of bugged. And we have Amin Harri. I haven't heard that name in a long while. 33 by now. Well-known player across Africa and Europe. I think he can speak a bunch of languages, can't he? Yeah, a bunch of, like, 5 different. I would have thought he would have put no more. However, our second final defeat. But you can probably guess that the Hugo Rangers is probably the team that will bring me the first Champions League title. The big question is, how long is it going to take? And with that, we are going to season number 4. Season 9 in managing for me. We are in 2031, and then we are going to be in 2032. We are in 2032, and we have won the league, obviously. That's not that much of a surprise, but we must start in second place, though. Transfers. We can look at them first. A bunch of people left, like Steven Moses, never that important of a player. Anyone important leaving? I don't think so. Most of these people have like 1-4 or something potential. Patrick Zudik, he actually has potential, but was at our team since the beginning. 163 potential, probably never played him. Then Sona Monga, who I think I actually signed. He left to Adele FC, 4, he actually left to them on loan. And then Tata Yonan Mampori left us, an amazing striker. On loan to Altaroon, I think they have cost to sign him. I'm actually not sure. Did I do it for the money? He didn't score in 10 games though, and it's kind of a disappointment. Didn't even score much in his last season at our club. That's probably why I've loaned him. But I've also signed a bunch of people. Archer Basinga, a left back, or right back. 131 countability, 189 potential. A first team player. Godwin Momo, 123 count, 164 potential, a winger. Playing 10 games, 1 goal, mostly off the bench. A squad player. Tagus Yudo, a star player for our team. Scoring 13 from only 16 starts, about 30 games in total from Shooting Stars. Russian second nationality. Okay, interesting story. Can he speak Russian? He is actually fluent in English, Russian, and Yoruba. Interesting family story, probably. 131 countability and 178 potential. Moses Alozi with 90 countability, 164 potential. Didn't play a single game, only 1-4 feeders, and I didn't even. I probably signed him on a free, didn't I? Yeah, on a free. Probably a bit too old, probably already a failed talent, and. But one for maybe the second team, I'm not sure. I think I signed mostly on potential, not even looking at the age. At that point, I mean, if I can have him, I should get him. Then also didn't play Ghulam Rahman. Central midfielder, central attacking midfielder. 73 countability, 160 potential. Yeah, not that great of a player. But played in World Cup qualifiers for an African team, I think for Pakistan. Or for Asian. For the Asian Confederation. And the last person, Dawa Yamtso, who also didn't play. Also attained 18 years old, 84 countability and 176 potential. Also only playing in the qualifiers for who? For Bhutan. I think our second player from Bhutan. Don't we have another Bhutanese player? I can't seem. Yeah, he is. He is from, also from Bhutan. However, did we finally win the Champions League? And have I finally won my first title in 2032? I mean, I've already won 3 league titles, or 4 actually. We have won the league title in every single season. Definitely a great time. First round was Olympique de Mangi from Gabon. We beat them 50-2. Okay, they are probably an amateur team. Then the first round, we beat, Real Bamako, I can't talk. Real Bamako, 10-1. won, and again not really that much of a match for Mali, then we are in the group stage again, and dominated the group stage, not a single loss, but we drew one game versus Krava United. Actually, I think they're also from Nigeria. Why the team from the same nation in the same group? But Nigeria definitely dominated the group. Mamelodi Sundowns and the team from Algeria out. Maybe a bit surprising. With that, we go to the quarterfinal where we beat up ASEC Mimosas 9-0. By now we are so overpowered, we beat them there from Code. Like, I think I've already uploaded a video where I try to conquer Earth with Code. Now I've conquered Code in Football Manager, then Tunis in the semi-final, 5-2, and then another final versus Al Ahly. Qua United, we could have had an all-Nigerian final, but we didn't get it. Sad. But did we finally do it? We finally did it, in the most scuffed way ever. 5-4, and we lost the second match 1-4. Like, this is incredibly cursed. Can we take a look at the matches? First leg 4-0, we certainly can't look at that. And the second leg 1-4. Raymond Nduka is the legend who gave us the Champions League. Can we take a look at it? Where can I look at it? Watch the goals. The game is loading and the goal to save us and bring us our Champions League glory. The first goal for Al Ahly, I think from Ali Hamid there. Toro, Monagwane not looking great. Devia to get back and Toro again. Toro, a really dangerous player, and obviously the second goal and Monagwane really not looking great. Both times the keeper was at fault. Now it's the third goal for Al Ahly. Toro to Ade. Toro definitely the man of the match for our opponents. But now, the all-important 1-3 that saved us our title. You can see it. Where do we have it? Nduka, and an amazing goal. In the most amazing fashion. Then Toro, directly from free kick. No reply. But Toro with 2 goals and 2 assists. What a man. Man of the match, probably. Where do we have him? He has a 9.4 rating. That's an insane rating for a single game. But with that, I finally completed Africa. Just took me 9 years and 2 episodes. I am not really sure how long this episode here will be. But we maybe can take a look at a bunch of and maybe some of our best people at Juninho. Where did they go? What happened to Juninho? Juninho actually went down and got relegated. They completely fell apart after I left. Maybe I wasn't great at team building. Probably most people from my era have already left. And they had to sack a bunch of people. Oh no. What have I done to them? Let's take a look at their best 11. Nawasep. Nawasep at UNAM still. I think he was like the best player for us there. Anybody else that was that important? I already forgot the names of most people because so many people after Team Nawasep, really the only person I can really remember. We can go to the where are they now section, have they all left the team. Only 5 people are still with the club. Anybody at a big team? Flamingos, they are okay, they're also in Namibia. Interesting logo. Decent logo actually. Did anyone make it to Europe though? I don't think anybody of the top team made it to Europe. Kinda disappointing. Why do we have Navasup again? Surely isn't he like, oh, he doesn't have any potential at all. I completely forgot that our team in Namibia was pretty garbage. Yeah, you can really see it here. And you really can't win anything with a Namibian team now looking at it. Comparing to our Inyugo Rangers team, which has a bunch of people with like best sniper, 140 overall. And I think I did it so that they always played the same team. No, I didn't. Okay, never mind. But with that, it's time for me to resign again. And at that point, they actually wanted to keep me. What would they actually do if I wanted to stay? They would increase the transfer budget. I would reject that and IP. Was I ever a legend or an icon? I don't think so. I'm only favorite personal. And I don't think I'm that permanently. But our first international title in 2032, and kind of a spoiler, Inyugo Rangers without me in like 50 years are going to go on an insane run. I don't know if I'm ever going to short that run, but remind me if I ever get that far, but they are insane later in the save. What would happen if I again apply to them? I've never tried it. Like, they wouldn't take me back today. They just want to have me, but yeah, I recently left the post. But with that, it's time to go to a different continent. And that continent is Asia, a bunch of different leagues, and I have a specific league loaded, which I could see myself joining. Da 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 da